Okay. Good evening, everyone. You can say good evening in the chat box, then I will know that you can hear me. Yes, thank you. Thank you. I'm looking at my chat box. Only one person is in the classroom? I think I see more students. Yes, thank you, Alicia. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, that's... You always, if you have a opportunity to type something in the chat box, you should type it. Yes. Yes, thank you, Kevin. Thank you. Because you never know, if I will ask the question, maybe you don't know the answer. That means at least good evening. It's a nice contribution. Okay, welcome to the review session, part two, okay? Because what I will do, I will just go through chapter seven. That means chapter seven was all of the techniques of integration. I mean, I will try to solve a few integration per each section, per each technique. Just the quick announcement. Oh, my pen is not working. Hopefully it is. The test will be open June 7th. I think in my email I type May, but I definitely check the dates. It's from 7th to 11th, but it's definitely June. Of course, May is gone. That means from June 7th, which is tomorrow. Okay, not tomorrow. Tomorrow. I'm a little bit, yes, crazy with my calendar. From today is Wednesday. That means from tomorrow, Thursday, until Monday, June 11th, the midterm test will be open. And I hope you have your time slot. You booked your time slot on the Examity. That means this will be your time to take the test. Okay. And you definitely checked the information on the main page. The exam info. Exam will contain 20 problems, each of them multiple choice. Okay, that's mean, and each of them is worth 5 points, 5 times 20, 100 points. Okay, that's mean half of the test will be probably integration and chapter seven. That's mean, let's see, if you have some integrals, I will be more than happy to answer them. Yes? Hopefully they are not so complicated, but even if they are complicated, I will always try to solve it for you. But I also prepare like a list of integrals. That would be good if you will understand the concept and know how to solve them, the integrals that I have in this presentation, and also a similar one, which of course covers the same concept. Then you will be perfectly fine on your test. Okay, let's start. Integral number one is integral, definite integral, from 0 to 1/2, inverse sine of x over square root of 1 minus x squared dx. That means theoretically, this is the integral not from chapter 7, okay, because we can definitely solve it without the techniques from chapter 7. That means, do you think you can tell me how can I solve it? I will solve for you, but maybe you can just tell me, I can just check if you, do you think what, like looking at these formulas, do they look like connected? They use substitution, yes, Kevin, thank you. Mm-hmm. Because as soon as I will let u to be inverse sine, we do have derivative, which is in the denominator, will be canceled out. Yeah? No, it's fine, it's fine. No, don't worry, Kevin. Okay, that's me, let's do the u substitution. Because what I see like two parts. I see sine, inverse sine of x, and I see the square root of 1 minus x squared. And they are definitely related to each other with respect to the derivative or antiderivative, whichever way we're looking at. Okay, inverse sine of x, then du, derivative of inverse sine of x, it's 1 over square root 1 minus x squared dx. And that means it's worth to know this. And we can see this part is in the integral. This will be du. Nothing to simplify. Integral will be simply u du. So nice and simple. The only thing is we need a new limits of integration. Okay. New limits. If x is zero, then u is defined as an inverse sine of zero, which of course is zero, okay? if x is half, u is defined inverse sine of half. That means sine, inverse sine of half. Sine for what angle is 1/2? Do you know? I'm looking at the chat box. Sine for what angle is 1/2? Do you know your unit circle? It's pi, pi over 3, pi over 4, pi over 6. Nice, yes, nice selection. Nice wide spectrum of, okay, which one shall I choose? Pi over 3, pi over 4, pi over 6, 666, right, 30 degrees, pi over 6. Mm-hmm. I think cosine of 1/2, I mean cosine of pi over 3 is 1/2. Okay, 6, right, okay, pi over 6. That means please make sure that you know your unit circle, especially for the main angles, the basic angles. Okay. Now, integral of u du is simply u squared over u, and we have to evaluate from 0 to pi over 6. Pi over 6 squared over 2, my writing is, and I don't have to put 0 squared over 2, but I will. Pi over squared over 36, 36 times 2. That means the answer is the correct answer. Okay, that we can see the u substitution, and if we do have a u substitution and limits of integration, always the new limits. Okay, but nice formula. I think this is chapter 6. Don't worry, we can get to chapter 7. Another integral. Integral, again, definite integral from 1 to e squared, 2 ln of x over x dx. Actually, what do you think? Did I jump to chapter 7 or it's the same? Thank you, Kevin. It's still the u substitution because we know what is the derivative of ln of x. What's the derivative of, it's 1 over x, right? Thank you. Thank you very much for the yes. Thank you. I really like to see everybody typing, which actually almost everybody is participating. Good. That's what we can see. As soon as I do this, du is sitting right there, dx over x. Okay, that means my integral is simply 2u du, because my loop, this is du. Okay. Oh my. And I can integrate. Integral of 2u is actually u squared. So nice. Probably that's the reason that the coefficient 2 was there. We need a new limit of integration. Can you compute faster than me? New limits. If x is 1, what will be the u value? And if x is e squared? The limits will be from 2 and 0. Yes, 0 to 2. From 0 squared. Okay, from 0 to 2, I see, but let's see, I mean e to the power of 4, I see some options, but let's see. U was defined as a ln of x, x is 1. What is ln of 1? Of course, I saw the answer, yes, thank you, 0. That means this is 0, from 0, and now u is defined again, ln of x, but x is e squared. And who can simplify this? Ln of e squared. It's just 2, because we remember we can take that power in front of the logarithmic function, and ln of e is 1, 2. Mm-hmm. That means it's from 0 to 2. Okay. I can maybe loop this. This is 2. Remember that property. Okay. That means we do have 2 squared minus 0 squared. Of course, we don't need 0. The answer is 4. Okay? Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, e to the power of 4. I can think where this comes from, but that's the correct answer. Okay, and Minho, I can see nice computation. Okay, that's been that. And I think that's again chapter 6. Okay, that's what is important on this slide, the blue arrow. Okay, make sure that you know how to simplify this logarithmic expression. I mean, everything is important, the u substitution, u limits, but the blue indication is good. Okay, let's see integral number 3. Evaluate integral of natural log of x over x squared dx. That means, what do you think? Is this still a u substitution or not really? Not really. I like yes, Kairi it and Kevin, no, I and Minh, everybody answer correctly. This is not a u substitution because this was the u substitution. 1 over x is the derivative of ln of x, but x squared will not let us cancel out stuff. That means, yes, I see the hint from Kairi. It's the integration by parts. Okay, that means we will do integration by parts because I see two parts, right? I see natural log of x and I see x squared. But maybe not, but yeah, let's see. Do you remember integration by parts can be applied directly if we see a product of two functions? I mean, I can still see this, the ratio, the quotient, but in order to use a formulas for my u, du, v, dv, whatever I will pick to assign the parts, I have to have two parts. That means I definitely have ln of x, and what is my second function that I have in my integrand? You remember this section? It's x. So yes, thank you. That's my point. Thank you. Mm-hmm. That's when you probably knew it. What I am, u du v dv. That means let me rewrite. And we do have natural log of x, no problem. And times x to the negative 2. That means my one part is ln of x. Another one is not x squared. It's x to the negative 2. That means, please remember, do not make the mistake on the test. Okay, and having two parts, I know that one of them must be u, one of them must be dv. Okay? And of course, I will place logarithmic. Yes? We remember I later, I late maybe, that's more English, okay? And L, logarithmic, that means L is the first letter on the list, then a. A is the algebraic function. That means it's easier to differentiate rather than anti-differentiate. That means this is my settings. Integration by parts. Ln of x and x to the negative 2. Okay, u, in order to get du, I have to get the derivative, which is easy, 1 over x dx. Having dv, I have to recover v, which means I have to anti-differentiate. What's the anti-derivative or integral to the x to the negative 2? Yes, okay, I see I was gonna write this. It will be x to the negative 1 over negative 1 if we use the power rule, but I can write like that. Yes, yes, actually, mm-hmm. Somebody write really, I don't know, because it's the nickname, x, negative x to the negative 1, which is 1 over x negative. Okay, perfect. And we remember the formula, u times v, multiply these two, and subtract an integral of this. That means uv minus an integral of v du. Oh, what I am doing? Okay, let me put the bar. I grab the bar. I don't know if you see this, probably. Oh, it's gone. Okay, and now I will put the formulas. Negative ln of x over x, vu, minus, and then 1 over x times another 1 over x, but negative. Negative ln of x over x, negative and negative is positive, and 1 over x times 1 over x, I'm gone, it's 1 over x squared, which we of course remember. Sometimes we have this case that we have to integrate exactly the same function that we did in the box. That means now ln of x over x, integral of x to the negative 2 is negative 1 over x. And no limits of integration, I can add a constant c. Okay, okay, that means this is nice. And this one, I can circle this. Of course, the blue part is the integration by parts, the formula, but my circle, it's telling me that I have to use x to the negative 2. Okay, that's me. You can see almost each slide has something, even if this looks like a just an integral, random integral. They are not really random. Okay, integral number 4, I believe. Okay, nice one. Integral from 0 to 1 arctangent of x dx. If you like, I can rewrite as an inverse notation, but that's the same. Yes, arctangent or inverse tangent is the same thing. I have to put 1, but my... Let me put the bar down. Okay, 1. Okay, that's what do you think? How can we solve this one? We only see one thing, inverse tangent. Do you remember what we have to do? If you can give me the hint, that will be great, and then I can solve it for you. It's still integration by parts? Maybe that's easy for you to answer. Oh, no, we don't remember. Oh, you can't hear me. You can hear me. No. No. Do not make this mistake because I believe, okay, integral of square root. Okay, that's even additional mistake. I can write something. Integral of this is tan inverse. Okay, but integral of tan inverse is not one over, it's not, we can't like switch the places. Yeah, that's the derivative, Kevin, right? Mm-hmm. Yes, no, Natasha, it's good. I can tell you it is a common mistake. But no, this is the integral of 1 over 1 plus x squared. And of course, we have to know this one, but we can't switch it. Yes, Kyrie, it's still, hang on, it's the integration by parts, okay? I can write the magic word I latte. I am actually messing up my Zoom. Hang on. Let me put the bar up there, because otherwise I can't change the bar. Okay, I. Can you see the letter I? I means an inverse function, and this is the inverse function. That means what we have? Integration by parts, of course, we need two parts. We only see one part. And do you remember how can we add another part, the second part that we will use? I can multiply inverse tangent by what number? Just 1. Mm-hmm. Just simply 1. That means I will multiply by 1. And now I have a function 1 and I have a function inverse tangent. U du v dv. And of course, I have to put inverse tangent of x here and I will put 1 dx. That was the suggestion for dv. Okay, integration by parts. And now derivative of inverse tangent is this. I can write down an antiderivative for 1 is x. And my magic formula, u times v, integral of v du. U times v minus an integral of v du. Excellent. And now x, tan inverse of x, minus an integral of x times 1 over 1 plus x squared. Okay? Always, we do have additional integral, but this integral is supposed to be easy. Do you know how to solve this integral, x over 1 plus x squared? I know the denominator looks like inverse tangent, but of course, inverse tangent doesn't have a function on the top. We can see it's only one. That's mean, right? Thank you for the suggestion. Is the u substitution. That's mean I will write, I will let u to be denominator. Du is 2x dx. I see x dx. That's mean I will divide by 2. X dx is simply half of du. Okay? And what I have, I will have x tan inverse of x minus 1/2 integral of 1 over u du. Denominator u du dx. I integrate on internet. Because we do. Okay, I will just rewrite now. Not what I want to. I have to wait. Maybe it's the Zoom account. It's for some reason making me right. I'm right. Extremely big delay. No. Okay, maybe now. Yes, we are back. Okay. Yes, okay. Now probably you can hear me. Okay. And integral of 1 over u, du is ln of u. But I will replace u inverse tangent 1/2 ln of 1 plus x squared. Okay, we still have a limit of integration. That means I will hug everything and I will use the original limits. And now you can see I don't really have to change for the new limits because my u variable, I did change for the original one. U was named 1 plus x squared. That means I have the entire expression in terms of x. I can use the original numbers from 0 to 1. Okay, let's substitute 0 and let's substitute 1. First of all, 1. That means we'll have 1 times inverse tangent at 1 minus 1/2 ln 1 plus 1, 2. And if I will put 0, 0 times inverse tangent at 0 is 0, and ln at 1 is 0. Okay, that means I don't have to put 0. 0 will give me 0. Okay, who can tell me this? Tangent, for what angle is 1? Because I have inverse tangent of 1. Pi over 4, now you're good. Yes, thank you. Pi over 4, and this one I can write ln of 2 over 2. And I believe this is my answer. Okay, that we do have few things, of course, integration by parts, the blue part, but please note that 1. Okay, if you only have one part and especially the inverse function, inverse sine, inverse tangent, multiply by 1 and use integration by parts. I can write by parts. Okay. Kevin, I don't know, that's a difficult question because everybody can see Kevin's question. He's asking if we facing a problem, we always facing the problem because we don't know what to do. You can try, if we can't use the u substitution, I will always try to maybe the integration by parts. Okay, I can't say like always, because we do have of course different techniques of integration, but probably I'm guessing what you like mean if you see maybe the product of two functions or the quotient. Yes, I would always say I will always try the integration by parts, because probably when you see a rational function or trigonometric, like the sine times cosine, you will probably use different methods. But yes, you can always, if the U substitution doesn't work, integration by parts. Okay? If integration by parts doesn't work, maybe it's the rational function, partial fraction, maybe trigonometric substitution. We have to just make sure that we know all of the methods of integration, okay, that we learn, because could be any integral related to that techniques. But yes, my answer is yes. Okay, another one. Evaluate the integral, okay, from 0 to pi over 3, x times secant square of x dx. Yes, this one is a nice integral. It's telling me right away what I have to do. Yes, do we know? What do you think? It's of course by parts. This one is no, because we definitely see a product of two functions. That means one of them, I will name you, one of them dv. And now I have x as an algebraic function and secant square of x as a trigonometric. That means algebraic, yes? Thank you. Mm-hmm. U will be x and dv is secant square of x dx, because we really know the antiderivative of this. Yes, mm-hmm, that's correct. Derivative of x is 1. Antiderivative of secant square of x is simply tangent of x. That's, we really have nice our parts. Okay, and my weird symbols, multiply these two and subtract an integral of the product of these two. Uv minus an integral of v du. Okay, and now maybe I can write here. I still keep my video. I think it's okay. Okay, x tan x minus an integral of tan x. Oh, wow. Okay. I will still apply the limits, but let's finish that integral. Integral of tangent of x. Do you possibly know that integral? Oh, okay. That's mean, yeah, it is ln, the natural log of secant of x. But I can tell you, because we have few formulas that we have to remember, but some of the formulas we can figure out. That means tangent, I can rewrite as a sine of x over cosine of x. Okay, and what you can do, you can apply the u substitution. You can let u to be cosine of x, and then you will solve it. But I can skip that part, and I can use that formula that somebody give it to me. Of course, I also know it. Okay, that means integral of tangent of x is ln of secant of x. You will get this if you will use sine over cosine and the u substitution. Okay, everything is done. Limits of integration stays the same from 0 to pi over 3. Oh, okay, let's get the values. I will substitute pi over 3 tangent at pi over 3 ln of secant of pi over 3, and then minus 0, tangent at 0 is 0, I can actually write this, and ln of secant at 0. That's mean now I didn't really ignore it, because actually secant at 0, what is secant at 0? You know the value is 1. And now what is ln, the natural log at 1? It's 0. Okay, that's it. Anyway, because I saw right away that this is 1. And I didn't want to ignore it, but everything is 0 anyway. Okay. Okay, and now this one, tangent at pi over 3. Do you know tangent at 60 degrees? I will copy this. If we do, it's a square root of 3. Mm-hmm. It's root 3. If you don't know, you can go through sine over cosine and you can simplify. It's root 3. Okay, minus ln. And what is secant at pi over 3? Secant at pi over 3? Secant is the reciprocal of cosine. 1/2 and then it's 2. Mm-hmm. Ln of 2. I don't need absolute value. Okay, I believe again this is my correct answer. Almost all of the answers are A, but please don't assume that on the test you will have different options too. Yes, you probably realize that because I was typing them and it's easier for me to keep the correct answer first. But no, on the test we really the system, the canvas is, it's, how do you say, shift them, okay? Shift the answers. Okay. Could you quickly do, yes, I can do the integral of tangent. Oh, yes, of course. Yes. Yes, you will know all of the answers if the answer. Okay, somebody who, Kyrie, is asking me integral of tangent. Okay, let me use different color.
What color I can use? Blue. No.
Okay, let's say dark blue. Okay, that means this integral, okay, is tangent. And what we will do, we will let u to be cosine, right, derivative, cosine of x, du, it's negative sine of x, dx, okay, and the integral will be, because we have negative, sine of x dx is du, that's mean 1 over u du. And then integral of 1 over u is ln of u, okay? Now I can substitute, let me switch off the video because it's covering half of my slide. Okay, now it's better. Now u is cosine of x. What I can also do, I can apply this negative ln of cosine of x to the negative 1. And 1 over cosine, of course, is secant. Right? That we can see, that's what we got. Okay? Now I think that means the dark color, the dark blue, it's the solution of the integral of tangent. Okay? Yeah? You can pause the video later and you can check the solution. Okay, that's mean I think we okay with the integration by parts. We kind of did almost all of the types, all of the kinds. Okay, let's see my next one. Okay, now section 7.2, just the trigonometric integrals. You probably remember sine theta times cosine theta. Of course, we have different powers. That's mean what we have. We have sine square theta and cosine cube. Okay, that's what we will do. We will attack the odd number and we'll rewrite this as a power of 2 and the single one, 1. And let me rewrite this. No. Okay, I will write actually underneath. Why this is okay? You probably see what I'm. Okay, maybe this will be the better position. Okay,
let me put one back. Okay, that's what we have. We do have integral from 0 to pi over 2.
I will keep sine square theta and then cosine square theta and cosine, just cosine. And since this is the single function, I will keep this one. And cosine theta is the derivative of sine. That means the entire integrand, this part, must be rewrite in terms of sine. Then I can use the u substitution. Okay, this one is fine, sine square theta. And we remember from the trigonometric, I mean the Pythagorean identity, cosine square theta is 1 minus sine square theta. Yes, thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. And I will copy this. That means now I'm fine. I can even underline again. The entire integrand is in terms of sine, except the last one, because this one I will save for du. Okay, let's let u to be sine theta. Du is cosine theta d theta. Excellent. So my integral is 3 u squared 1 minus u squared, and this is simply du. Let's distribute 3 u squared. I will distribute this. U squared times u squared is u to the power of 4 du. And let's integrate. 3 u squared integral is actually u cube, because we do have this. And 3 u to the power of 4 is 3 u to the power of 5 over 5. And let's actually use the new limits of integration.
Okay, I will use the new limits because I don't want to rewrite in terms of. Okay. New limits. If x is 0, u is sine of 0, actually not x, theta, because everything was in terms of theta. If theta is pi over 2, u is sine of pi over 2. Okay, sine of 0 and sine of pi over 2. Sine of 0, who can tell me this? It's 0, thank you. And sine of pi over 2? It's yes, oh, thank you. Too fast, good. I mean, no, not too fast. Good, good. 0 and 1. Okay, that means 0, I can ignore it because 0 will give me 0. 1 cube is 1. 5, 1 to the power of 5 will be also 1. That means only this, which is 2 over 5. Of course, again, the option A.
Okay, that we can see this is like a trigonometric integrals, just sine times cosine. And we have to like figure out, that means what I did, I look at the odd exponent. Okay, and I split for the square and the single one. The single one we need to be cancel out to be du. Okay, and now I think I have another one, tangent secant. Okay, tangent cube theta and secant to the power of 7. That means both of them are odd numbers. Yeah, that's what I will do. I will do the same thing what I did with cosine cube. I will take this odd numbers and split for square and the 1. This one will be to the power of 6 and 1, because I always have to pull out the single one. That's what I will have. I will have tangent square, secant to the power of 6, and now I will have secant tangent. And secant times tangent, secant theta, tangent theta, this is derivative of what function? Secant theta times tangent theta. That's derivative of what function? Secant. Mm-hmm. Oh, somebody was, okay, Kevin was giving some hint, which was actually good. Okay, that means the box, the single secant and single tangent multiplied together is the derivative of secant. That means my entire integrand, I mean rest of them, must be rewrite in terms of secant. This one is good. Secant 6 theta. I will copy my box. Okay. And now from the Pythagorean identity, tangent square theta. Do you remember how can we rewrite tangent square in terms of secant? Secant square theta minus one. Very good. Okay, we're ready for u substitution.
Let u to be secant theta. Du is in the box. Secant theta, tan theta, d theta. Okay, that means this will be u squared minus one, u to the power of six, and this is my du.
Excellent. Let's distribute. U squared times u to the power of six is u to the power of eight. We adding the exponents, times one will be just u to the power of six.
I can highlight, no, maybe blue color, no. I just distribute this.
Okay.
U to the power of nine over nine,
u to the power of seven over seven. Finally, not the definite integral. Okay, that's me. Now, instead of u, we can substitute back secant theta. And which answer is correct? Who can tell me? Secant to the power, of course, a. What could be different? 7, 7 plus the constant of integration. Okay. Yeah. That means the same idea. Yes, the blue part is quite important. Okay. That means that I think that's, yeah, that's enough for section 7.2. Okay, let's see next one. Oh, big one. 7.3. Oh, hang on, we do have a question.
If one even, one odd, are we using the tangent?
Kevin. Because if you will check my section, the 7.2 section, which actually is this one, I believe I only cover the case if both of the exponents are even or both of the exponents are odd. However, you may have one even, one odd, but what you have to do, you have to really look how they are like distributed, like. You may try to use in a tangent, or you may also actually try to use secant, like mean the substitution. You have to kind of figure out what you can pull out in that box. If you can pull out the secant square, which of course the secant square is the derivative of tangent, then you will do tangent. If you can do like I did, secant tangent, then you can do secant. And I can tell you sometimes if one exponent is even, one odd, you can actually do both. Both of the methods will work. You can let u to be secant, or you can let u to be tangent. Okay, you have to kind of like see how the exponents, the powers are like spreaded out. Okay, you will get, if you understand the concept, it will be so easy. Okay, but I can only tell for yes, I can only tell that if both of them are odd, we always do secant. If both of the exponents are even, we always do tangent. But if they are like one is odd, one even, then we have to figure out, which is also not a difficult task. No, it's okay. It's just, that's what I'm saying. In the video, I'm only talking about two evens and two odds. What you're asking for one even, one odd exponent. Which that's the moment that we have to kind of like, we have to decide it, okay? And understanding the concept, it's so easy. Okay, no, I'm not expecting that we like remember everything. I mean, it's the midterm review, but still we have time. Yes, yeah. Okay, let's see this one. That means this one is 7.3, trig substitution. It's not bad, okay? Probably you understand. I mean, you recognize. That's the main thing is to recognize what type of integral I'm looking at. Okay, that's mean trig substitution. And who can tell me
what shall I let you be? Like, I mean, not you, the x.
What substitution can I use? It's definitely sine theta. But what coefficient we need? 7. Thank you.
7 sine theta. Excellent. Dx. 7 cosine theta d theta. Okay. Let's see what we have. 49
sine square theta. 49 minus 49 sine square theta, right, just instead of x, and dx is 7 cosine theta d theta. Okay,
I definitely will simplify this square root. 49 can be, I can factor out 1 minus sine square theta, and then the square root. Square root of 49 and square root of 1 minus sine square theta.
1 minus sine square theta,
of course, is cosine square theta. Square root of 49 and square root of cosine square is cosine, because the domain is letting me do this. Okay. That means my integral is,
actually, can I simplify here? This will be 7 cosine theta. Then I can
save space, which means I can simplify this and this,
because that's the same. And now I end up with 49 sine square theta. Okay. Yes, makes sense, because the, okay, that's mean actually sine square theta is an integral from the section before, 7.2. And hopefully we remember that we will use one of the trick formulas, sine square theta or cosine square theta. We have to use the half angle formula. 1 minus cosine of the, yes, thank you, cosine of 2 theta over 2. Let me save space. Okay. 1 minus cosine 2 theta over 2. I will move to outside, and actually I can integrate. Integral of 1 d theta is theta. Integral of cosine 2 theta is sine of 2 theta over 2, because it's that 2. And plus the constant. Okay, almost done. The only thing is, since I started with the x variable, I have to end with x. So let me do one thing. Theta. So, because I can get from my substitution, I will build a triangle. Yes, and we will need a sine, right, sine theta is x over 7. But the thing is, I don't know what is sine of 2 theta. That means I need another formula, which is the double angle. I can use this. Sine of 2 theta is 2 sine theta times cosine theta, because I really need a single angle. Then I can cancel out. And now I have to rewrite theta, and I can find sine theta and cosine theta. Okay, that means yes, I will use the hint, the Kevin's hint, that sine theta is x over 7. Okay, I can build my triangle. Now, one more thing, if sine theta is x over 7, theta will be inverse sine of x over 7. That means I can rewrite inverse sine of x over 7. 49 over 2. Okay. But I also need my triangle. Right? That's theta. And sine is x over 7, and the ratio in the right triangle for sine is opposite
over hypotenuse. That means if this is x, this is 7, this will be 49 minus x squared.
Pythagorean theorem. And actually, I don't know if I mentioned this during like solving this integrals before, but can you see what I've got? The square root?
This square root is identical to the square root in the original integrand.
Can you see this? And always, always is the case. That means building the triangle and looking for the other ratio, you will, of course, you will have two parts, I mean two sides of the triangle. Finding the third one, remember, it has to match to this square root. If not, probably we make some small mistake. Okay, and now I can read, actually sine theta was given, and cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, which is 49 minus x squared. Okay, and I think I can leave
the answer like this one.
Okay, that means this integral is also quite, yes, quite long. I mean, it's nice because we can save time on different questions. If we end up having this question, we need just a few extra minutes because we're doing the trig substitution. We have to simplify, and then we end up with another integral, sine square theta, which it's a little bit of process, double angle, half angle. Yeah, it's a few formulas. Also, I will pause the video on that integral, or just copy the integral and try to solve it on your own. Cover the solution, solve it, and check against this solution. Oh, okay, question. How do we do the integral of tangent square or tangent cube? Oh, tangent square. Actually, I think I have tangent square. Tangent cube. Oh, we will not ask tangent. I think tangent cube, you have to try the trick, integration by parts. But tangent square is the nice one. Okay. For tangent square, I don't know if the U substitution works. But tangent cube, oh, hang on, tangent cube. Tangent cube, I think for tangent cube, we may try the U substitution. Okay, let's see, hang on. I will take me a note, tangent square. Actually, tangent square is important. We can try tangent cube, okay? But let's see, tangent square is relatively easy, but tangent cube we can figure out. Okay, let's see what else I have. This one. Okay, another trig substitution. Actually, let me skip my integrals. Okay, I do have empty slide. Since the question was asked.
Okay. Tangent square of x dx. That means what we can do for tangent square, we can rewrite tangent square as a secant square of x minus 1. Okay. Yeah, I also thought about. I don't know, Kevin, what you're before. Okay.
Yes, okay. That means, can you see tangent square? We can rewrite as a secant square minus 1, right? And what's the integral of secant square? Who can tell me? Okay, everybody is, yeah, it's just tangent, right? That means it's tangent x. What's the integral of 1? It's just x. Done. Okay, that means I will write this down. Okay, that's actually nice. Good question. Good intuition. Okay, but
tangent cube. Okay, I will try this.
I will try. Oh no, this doesn't work well. We know integral of tangent, but secant square. Oh, if I will rewrite tangent square as a secant square minus 1, but doesn't make, because then I have to, or maybe, because I don't think integration by parts will work. I know this one, but derivative of tangent is secant square. And I will multiply secant square by secant to the power of 4, maybe integration by parts. Oh, What suggestion? Okay, okay, everybody is thinking. Let you to be secant. But if you is secant, then derivative is secant tangent. And we don't have that secant, we only have tangent. Yes, 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 that's what secant tangent.
Okay, let's see, secant square of x minus 1 times tangent, then we will distribute secant, oh, secant
square of x tangent, okay, okay, you're right, minus tangent. Okay, yes, yes, actually makes sense. Because this one, we know integral of tangent, I just solved today, it's negative, that means this will be positive, ln of secant. And this one, can we just do the u substitution?
Yeah, you see, that's the thing. I can tell you, I didn't probably integrate tangent cube for many. I will let u to be tangent. And du is secant square x dx. That means secant square is, which this will be an integral of u du.
Okay, and u squared over 2.
And u is actually, let me do this on the side and I will put the final answer. U squared, oh no, not u squared, just u. Du, u squared over 2, tangent square of x over 2. Okay, that means this one is just tan square over x over 2. Okay, because that's the u substitution. U and this is dx. Okay, okay, that means tangent cube, that's the final answer. Tangent square of x over, yeah, okay, okay, thank you for all of your comments. Okay, that means this is, that means what is actually important, and this will be helpful, this formula. Yes, we are actually using a lot in different like integrals. But tangent square of x is secant square minus 1. Because we like secant square, we know the integral of secant square. Okay, good questions. Mm-hmm, really good. Okay, let's see what I have. What I will suggest, I will simply suggest to take like any integrals. I don't know exactly when is your time to take the test, but if you still have a little bit of days, let's like integrate like 5 integrals a day. Okay, and you will see like how you will build your confidence. Oh, the last day. Okay, okay. It's still okay. You can still, yeah, you can still have the whole night
after I finish my session. Okay, let's see. Okay, can you, because what I have this one and I have the, I still want to solve few. Okay, let's do it. Let's finish whatever I have because I don't want to miss any. Oh, Kevin, you always do the, at the last, you always work at the last minute. Oh, no, no good. Okay, it's good that I switched the video. You're not going to have, how do you say, dirty look from your teacher? No, we have to work every day, every day. You don't know the message from your instructor? Work, yes. I know, I do have few students, they always ask me for some extension and they always have a reason. I know, I know. Okay, I still like my students. Okay, let's see. This one, who can tell me, what substitution? What trick substitution? Secant, thank you. And what is the coefficient in front of the secant? 2, great.
2 secant theta. Dx is 2, derivative of secant, secant tangent. And let's see what we will get. 2 secant
square theta, I mean 2 squared, which is 4. Minus 4, x is 2 secant theta, and dx is 2 secant tangent. Okay.
I will cancel out this. I will cancel out this. And okay, I have to simplify my square root, right? That means I will underline, and I have 4, which I can factor out. Secant square theta minus 1, square root of 4. Oh, and again, secant square theta minus 1 is tangent square theta. This is 2, and this is just tangent. Okay, that's me. My numerator is simply 2 tangent
times another tangent, because everything else is cancelled out. Oh, look at this, tangent times tangent. Tangent square theta. What's the nice surprise, right? Yes, that's the reason that I said it's a good question. Okay, we remember this, secant square theta minus 1. And maybe I can save space. Secant, integral of secant square is tangent, integral of 1, theta is theta. Of course, plus the constant of, oh no, plus the constant of integration. Okay.
What was my substitution? Secant theta is x over 2. I can build a triangle. This is theta. Secant, what ratio is secant? Can you tell me? I think I know the answer, but I just want to ask you. Secant theta is
x over 2. Which side will be x? Which side will be 2? We know we do have adjacent, opposite, and hypotenuse.
That means secant is?
Who can tell me the ratio for secant? Oh, I hope you're not sleeping.
Oh, no, but yes, that's what I was looking for, h over a.
Hypotenuse, which is
x over adjacent. And now we will calculate the third side, which will be square root of x squared minus 4. And can you see that it's the same like in the original integrand? That means we did a good job. Okay. 2, and I need tangent. Tangent is opposite over adjacent, which this will be square root x squared minus 4 over 2 minus theta. Theta is simply the inverse, secant inverse of x over 2.
Okay, really good. That's me. Nice, actually nice integral. That's the trig substitution and tangent square. Really nice. Okay. Okay, that's mean I only have 2, because we do have one more. Let me quickly ask.
I thought that I type. Okay, what about this integral? Really fast.
What substitution you will use? Just tangent. Mm-hmm.
This will be tangent theta. Dx is secant square theta d theta. I just want to cover all of them. Okay, that means 1 plus
tangent square theta, secant square theta d theta.
Let's simplify the square root. 1 plus tangent square theta, of course, is secant square theta, of course, is secant. That means this will go on the top,
and this will be just secant theta. Secant theta. We can cancel out
one of them.
Oh, okay, that's another nice. What I can tell you, we don't, yes, thank you. We may remember that, but I don't really ask, it's actually secant theta plus tangent theta, yes. We normally not really, I always don't really like to ask you to memorize this. I mean, you can I can give you the answer. Integral of secant theta is ln of secant plus tangent. Of course, I got the answer from you. But I can tell you,
we may ask you, what color I can use, to stop there.
Okay, that means you probably saw like a type of question that using an appropriate trig substitution, what will be the integral in terms of theta? That means that's your answer. Okay, that means we may ask you to stop there. Yes, I don't really necessarily ask for this because, I mean, you can memorize or you can look the solution in the textbook, but don't worry, I will not ask you to integrate secant theta, okay? But we may ask you to do the whole integral, but this will be your final answer, okay? Yeah, I know, it's lots of stuff to memorize, which I'm always trying to minimize the stuff that you have to remember. Of course, we do have lots of like important stuff that we have to, it's no other way. But any additional things and any things that we can derive, we don't have to. That means in case of this question, this will be your final answer. See? Integral of secant theta. And yes, whatever formula is this, everybody can find out. Okay. That we did this one. We have last section. Let's see. Free integrals. This one. Partial fraction decomposition. Right? No square root. Oh, Natasha, what are you asking?
Hang on. I see. Wait. Is that the same thing as the derivative of the tan inverse?
Oh, which one? No, these are the square roots. Okay, you answering. Hang on.
Ooh. He asked if that was the same inverse tangent.
Oh, no, that's the derivative. I don't know exactly what you're asking.
I can write one more time this one. Yes, this is inverse tangent.
If we have
inverse tangent, okay, I did solve this one. We have to go by parts. Okay.
I don't know exactly if that's the question, but I'm assuming. Oh,
do we know this integral? 1 minus x squared?
Who can tell me? Okay. Thank you, Natasha, for answering. I just got lost. Can you tell me this integral?
Whoever, yes, just simply inverse, arc sine.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And in case if you have to integrate inverse sine, you have to do the same thing like inverse tangent by parts. Okay, let's see this one. Okay, that's what we see. We see two factors. We see x minus one and we see x plus two. That means that will be the partial fractions.
Okay, and I can even integrate a
ln of x minus 1, b ln of x plus 2,
plus the constant c.
But what is a, what is b? Let's get it. My numerator x plus 5 will be exactly the same if I will get a common denominator on this side. That means a, I will multiply by x plus 2, b, I will multiply by x minus 1. X plus 2,
x minus 1. And now let's pick the value 1 for x. 1 plus 5 is 6. This is gone. 3a.
This is giving me a 2. That means this is 2.
And if I will pick for x negative 2, negative 2 plus 5 is 3.
negative 1 and negative 2 is negative 3b. B is negative 1.
Okay, that means which option is good?
Who can tell me? A is 2 and B is negative 1. Who can pick the answer?
Oh, no. Are you there?
I hope you're there. You can't see the correct answer? See, yes.
Thank you. I was just waiting for you. 2, we can see 2 and negative 1.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That means that's case 1. Let's look at this one, case 2. Because what we have? We have x plus 5 twice times x plus 5 and times x minus 1. That's when we're going to have
a fraction with x plus 5 squared, and x minus 1.
Still A, B, and C, because all of them are the linear one.
Okay. I can also integrate, but okay, let's find A, B, and C. 36 is the numerator.
If I will combine all of them, I have to make, yes, the common denominator. That means now, coefficient A has underneath x plus 5. And the common denominator is x plus 5 squared. That means I need multiply A by additional x plus 5 and times x minus 1.
X plus 5 and x minus 1. Now B.
B has x plus 5 squared. The only thing that is missing is x minus 1. And C has only x minus 1. What is missing? X plus 5 squared.
Excellent. Let's see. If x is 1, what we getting? A is gone, B is gone. 5 plus 1 is 6 squared, 36 C. C is 1. Good. If x is negative 5, what we getting? 36, A is gone, C is gone, negative 5 and negative 1 is negative 6B. B is 6. Now 6, negative 6. Negative times negative will give me positive 36. Okay, and we remember we only have two zeros. That means now I will just pick another one. Let me pick 0.
And pick any number.
Let's substitute instead of x 0. 0 and 0, this will be negative 5a. 0 will give me negative b and 25c. Let's see, negative 5a. Negative b will be positive 6. 25c will be just 25 times 1. Okay.
Well, let's solve it for a.
What we have? Negative 5a. 25 and 6 is 31. Subtracting 31, I have 5. Really nice. A is negative 1. Okay. That's me. That's.
I'm just trying to divide. Negative 1, x plus 5.
B is negative 6. X plus 5 squared. And C is 1. Okay. So now, this integral is easy.
Negative ln of the denominator. This one is easy. Ln of the denominator plus the constant C. And now,
we do have this one.
This one, we have to do the U substitution. Okay, that means I will let U to be...
Why does B have, oh, what I did?
Oh, hang on, did I make some mistake?
Why, oh, okay, that's me, you watching me, good. Why does B have x minus 5 squared, not just x minus 5? Isn't actions for transactions? Hang on. First of all, it's x plus 5, right? Eric, you, because you're writing x minus 5.
Okay, I don't wanna. Yes, x plus 5. Okay.
That's fine. And you're asking me why b does
square. And not just, oh, no, because we have to do, I don't know if you remember case two. You can really maybe watch the video again. Okay, let me explain.
If we have just function, let's say x to the power of 6, x minus 1 to the power of 2, and just x plus 4. But we can see we have x to the power of 6, x to the power of 2, and x. We will have 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 because it's the degree of the denominator is x to the power of 9.
Okay, that's the reason that we have to include every single partial fraction. That means I will include x, I will include x squared, I will include x cubed, I will include, oh, hang on, that's not 1. This will be a, b, c, d, x to the power of 4, x to the power of 5, x to the power of 6. And then x minus 1, x minus 1 squared, and then the last one, no problem. Okay, that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because what's happened? Let's see this one. If I will take this fraction and this fraction, these two fractions, what is the common denominator for x and for x squared? The lowest common denominator. Right? We can see the lowest common denominator is x to the power of 6. If I will take this one, it's still x to the power of 6. If I will take all of these fractions, the lowest common denominator for all of them is x to the power of 6. That means maybe some of them will be not there. But I still have to include all of the partial fractions.
All of them like a multiple of x, which goes to the x to the power of 6.
And of course, a, b, c, d.
Okay,
that means that, yeah, we can't really say, it's not like that I'm taking x and x squared and the common denominator is x cubed. No.
It's still x squared, the lowest common denominator. Yeah, it's like 1/2 plus 1/4. Yes, the common denominator is 4. Okay, I know. It's
always, this case is always confusing. Okay, where is my integral? Okay, that's me. Let's finish this one. I will let x plus 5 to be u. Du is dx. That means it's not a problem. And then I will have 6 over u squared. And the integral of u squared, I mean 1 over u squared is negative 1 over u, which actually u is x plus 5. And negative will give me positive because that was negative. I can keep it this way. And I can copy this one, and I can copy x plus 5. Okay, that means you can probably see this integral. I can circle using different color. This integral is this. Okay, that means if it's the quantity squared, it's like u squared, which will be negative 1 over u, negative 1 over x plus 5. Yeah, please don't say ln of the denominator. That's not the case. Okay, that means yes, this slide includes the partial fraction. Do not make mistake on this, and don't make mistake on the green integration, the green integral. Okay, and I have one more, and actually I have two more. But one more is the case, yes, it's the case 3. Okay. That's me. Let's
solve it. I know that it's quite late, but I think you can manage. I will copy this
And we always have to start like with factoring out the denominator. That means I can only factor out x.
Okay. That means now what I have. I have x
and I have x squared plus 4 because this is irreducible. I can't factor out further. And now I will put a. And can I ask you, I hope it's not too late, can you tell me what shall I put on the top of the quadratic form? Bx plus c. Thank you. That's important. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, you're ready to take your test. Okay, and the same process. Right? My numerator, 3x squared minus 2x plus 8, will be equivalent to a. I have to multiply by x squared plus 4. And bx plus c, I will multiply by x. And the only thing is, I can pick 0. And I have 8. This is gone. 4a, a is 2. And that's the only 0 that I have. Okay, let's pick 1. If I will pick 1, I have 3 minus 2 plus 8, 4a plus b plus c. This is 1, this is 9. 4a, or actually 4a is 8 plus b plus c, then b plus c is 1. Okay, I will find another equation. Let me pick negative 1. Negative 1 will give me 3 plus 2 plus 8. Oh, did I make the mistake? Yes, 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 I see this. This is not 4a, it's 5a. Thank you. That means this is 10. 10, and this will be negative 1. Please check, okay? Please check, okay, okay, I see that. Any other students are watching me? Good. 5a is now correct, 10, and subtracting 10 will be negative 1. Okay. Now, negative 1 will also give me 5a plus b minus c, because negative and negative is positive. Okay, that we do have 13, 10, b minus c. That means b minus c is 3. Subtracting 10, okay. Now I can combine these two. B plus C is negative 1, B minus C is 3. And by elimination, I can add 2B, C is gone, 2, 3 minus 1, B is 1. If B is 1, who can calculate C for me? Negative 2. Please do the arithmetic for me. B is 1, 2, negative 2. Okay, that we do have all of the values. Let's see. A is 2, 2 over x. B is 1, 1x, minus 2. Okay, we do have another integrals. Do I have slide? Okay, this one, let me write one more time. Okay, now for this case, for case 3, I will split this integral. Okay, that means I will write x over x squared plus 4, and I will write 2 over x squared plus 4. Okay, this is still an integral. That means you can see what I did. I did split for two integrals because it's much, much easier. Especially I recognize my denominator. Okay, let me show you one thing.
Do you remember this integral?
X squared plus we know this one, x squared plus 1.
Okay, it's just inverse tangent. But what about x squared plus additional number, a squared? How this a squared is affecting inverse tangent?
Will be x over a and 1 over a. Okay, that means if we have an integral
x squared plus 4, this will be half inverse tangent x
over half.
And what about maybe one more? X squared plus 25. 1 over 5. Oh no, not integral. And x over 5.
1 over 5, x over 5. Okay, that means it's worth to remember this rather than like factoring out and applying a u substitution. Okay. So I mean, let's come back. Okay, this, you know what, I will add a slide. I just don't like squeezing everything. And of course, Okay. That's mean what we have. Let me move everything on the other side.
2 over x plus 1x, x squared plus 4. What was this? Minus 2. Okay. This one is easy, 2 ln of x. This one, we did this integral today. Okay, that means if you will do the u substitution, you will have 1/2 ln of denominator. And this one, we have 2. We can see I am putting down that 2. And then x squared plus 4 is 1/2
tan inverse x half. Which of course 2.5 will be gone. That means I'm sure you can manage the middle integral too. Because we can let u to be x squared plus 4 and then 2x, 1/2 is the output of the u substitution, and you can let u to be denominator, ln of u is the integral. Okay, that means that's the final answer. That's what we have. Let me see. Yeah, this is good hint. Okay, please split and please take care of both of them. Okay, that's almost everything. I do have one more, this one. Okay, and I promise it's the last one. And thank you for staying with me so late. You're actually doing excellent. Okay, what do you think? What we should do? Normally, looking at the rational function, we will try to factor out the denominator. But do you think we can factor out? Can I factor out this expression? X squared plus 6 plus 25? I don't think we can do this. That means you probably remember we will complete the perfect square, right? We will complete the square. That means I need x squared, 6x, and I need one more quantity. Do you know, in order to complete the square, what will be this number in the box?
9. Yes,
3 squared. I have to take the coefficient of x, divide by 2, and square. 3 squared is 9. And since I took 9, 9 plus 16 is 25. Because I have to manage.
I mean, I have to match to 25. Okay. And now I have x plus 3 plus 25. And do you recognize this integral? I can still let u. I mean, we don't even have to do the u substitution because du is dx. But just for you to see easier, u squared plus 25. du. okay, which is inverse tangent
of x over 5 and 1 5. Not x, still u.
And now I can put instead of u, x plus 3. Done. Really nice integral. Okay, some questions. I'm confused. I thought it was 25 minus. Yes, 25 minus 9 is 16.
Yes. I did put 16, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, why is it 20? Because it was 25. I mean, that's the problem that somebody gave me, let's say. But then
you put it as a 20.
Oh, oh my gosh, of course it's
16. Thank you. I think it's too late.
Oh, no, no.
Thank you. Of course, 16. I can even make different. 16.
Probably the reason I put 25, because 25 is a perfect square too. Oh, no, of course. Thank you. Thank you, Paul. No, 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 it's 16.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, thank you. I didn't, I'm not just testing your like, how do you say, if you're watching me or not, I'm not testing you. I make the mistake. Okay, 16. Of course, I have to carry on the 16. Mm-hmm. Yes, we are all, you all awake. Thank you. Really good. Okay, that means make sure one more time. Do I have something? Okay, I have this one, but we don't have to really.
It's similar,
but don't worry. Okay, that means this one is quite, yes, quite important. And I would say all of the integrals that I solved is quite important. Okay, that means you can see, like, even me, like, talking and answering your questions, and it only took like an hour and like 90 minutes. That means probably when you will go through the integrals, you will sit in the quiet room, nobody will be talking to you. You can definitely solve them quite quickly. I mean, definitely faster than I did. And this will be excellent practice. Okay? Because if you will not miss any integral from this presentation, you can definitely do like 60% of your test will be perfect. Okay, and of course we still have chapter 6. Okay, that means please, yeah, please watch this video again. Please all look at the slides, solve the integrals, and you can actually solve any integral. It's always good practice. Okay, thank you very much for tonight.